presents are good, but parties are great. Mr. Birthday's true talent was organizing parties and birthday parties. Like for the time when Mr. Greedy's birthday came around, Mr. Birthday made two giant marvelous chocolate cakes. One for Mr. Greedy, who gobbled it up in 3 seconds, and one for all the guests. Or, like the time he organized a party for Mr. Jelly without any balloons, because Mr. Jelly is afraid they might go pop and then he would run away from his own party. And the time when he organized a party with silly hats for Mr. Silly, because he's silly. You should have seen those hats. But the biggest, best birthday he ever organized was for Mr. Happy. He made so many games, like Mrs. Lucky always won all of them, except for one, which was the magic chairs. Nobody knew who won which one, because Mr. Bum threw all the chairs and he fell into them. But Mr. Happy had a marvelous time, especially when he saw his presents and the giant cake. But before going, Mr. Happy whispered to Mr. Birthday, "Don't forget the birthday that comes this time." On Saturday, of course, he said and ran away.
Whose birthday comes on Saturday? How could I have forgotten? Usually I'm so good with birthdays. I should go home and look at my birthday list. He thought as he rushed home. He felt quite worried because this was his talent. How could he mess this up? He opened his birthday book. But there was no birthday for this Saturday. No Mr. Bump, no Miss Dotty. Who could it be? Mr. Birthday thought until when it was Tuesday, he called Mr. Happy. Mr. Happy, you have to tell me whose birthday it is. I have to organize the party. Ha ha ha! Don't be silly. You know whose birthday it is. If you don't, then you'll know soon enough, Mr. Happy said. Mr. Birthday said as he scratched his head. He kept on thinking while Mr. Happy kept on planning. Finally, Saturday afternoon came and Mr. Birthday rushed to Mr. Happy's house. What is it? He said as he rang the bell. Nobody opened the door. Mr. Happy, are you okay? Mr. Birthday asked. He flung open the door. Everything was dark. He thought. He switched on the light and then all the Mr. Men and all the little Miss Yeg, "Happy birthday, Mr. Birthday!" Mr. Birthday blushed, then he smiled, then he began to laugh. My own birthday. So Mr. Birthday had the best birthday in the world and went on organizing new birthdays.